Once upon a time, there was no fun, and children were sad and quiet. In fact, there was little of anything truly childlike once upon a time. No laughter or jumping rope or running, no catching fireflies, no chasing an ice cream truck. Worst of all, though, there was no love once upon a time. No family, no home, no hope. It was a sad, quiet story until we heard it, and we made it our mission to rewrite it. We chose hope and courage as our themes, and with the help of many special people, we added all kinds of happiness, like hugs, kisses, caring friends, and loving families. That's how ChinaCare, a story of health, healing, and the power of love, a story that changes people, came to be. When one is touched, two are changed. Not the end. It's hard to say how different Kylie's life would have been. She was just a Peapod, 18 months old, and she was just adopted. But now her life's pretty cool in sunny California. Kylie shares her bonds with her family, Leilani, Clark Smith, and her big sister, Kiara. She knows she's adopted, just like her mom, but with life as an orphan child long behind her, Kylie has become an all-American girl. She's known for leaving her socks and shoes all over the floor and using a bit too much bath soap for her experiments. She enjoys playing lightsabers with her dad and wants to be a warrior like Mulan. But she also loves to cuddle her stuffed animals, Pug and Tiger. Seven years ago, that's when we first saw Isabella. 7 years ago, clinging to a new anchor, but adrift in a fast-moving current of strangers. Speaking no English and very little Chinese, she reached out to her brother, Skylar, and he helped her communicate. She hoarded food in her cheeks and hid things that were given to her so that no one would take them away. She had to be taught daily the family was not going to leave her. Isabella, or Iz as she's known, has come a million miles from that part of her journey, and the Carmen family has had the good fortune to experience many firsts that might never have been. Like her first plane ride home, her first freaked-out steps on the beach, her instant love of snow, and of course, her first father-daughter dance. Says her mom, Sherry, about life with Iz, "Thank you, ChinaCare. You are forever a part of our family." If ever a ChinaCare story was about the triumph of love and perseverance over adversity, this is it. And as young adults, Grace and Jamie are truly inspirational. She is Grace in every sense of the word, as in loving daughter and sister, as in a calm kindness shining straight from her heart, as in a figure skater, animal lover, fan of classical music, as in quirky, endearing sense of humor. Now, 16, Grace's dream is to marry a professor, study languages, and experience other cultures. And someday, she hopes to adopt a little girl of her own. Says Mom Kelly, she is still, after all these years, the best snuggler. More than anything. If you really knew the pain he's experienced, you might assume Jamie could only have hate in his heart. On the contrary, he's a strong, gentle young man. And that's only the beginning. Jamie's a straight-A student, a leading gymnast, an accomplished artist, and was just accepted into the Milwaukee School of Ballet. He wants to someday become a psychologist. He wants to help other people who suffer. We love these stories because they're triumphant, and you've helped to tell them. You've helped create them. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. You're helping change people's outcomes, writing a happy ending for everyone. And the story never would have existed without you. And so, we need to get our happy ending on. And I'd like to enlist some special friends to help me out with it.